for the banking theory the key value is depend on the direction of the wall is vertical. That means if we have the wall is not in vertical plane, okay, we will draw the line in vertical plane, okay, and the pressure will acting on this plane, okay, instead of the wall. And another case, okay, if the soil surface, okay, with the alpha degree from the horizontal plane, okay, in this case, Rankin make some correction to the Ka and Kp, okay, by taking account of the alpha degree, okay, then we will get Ka equal to cos alpha multiplied with cos alpha minus square root of cos square alpha minus cos square of phi divided by cos alpha plus square root of cos square alpha minus cos square phi. And for the Kp, okay, it will be the same equation, okay, just opposite the this mark, okay. For the Kp will be positive, okay, to the upper part and negative in the lower part. Okay. And Pa, okay, will acting parallel with the ground surface. Okay, that means the Pa will have the angle with alpha angle also from the horizontal plane. And if it is the sand, okay, that means the stress distribution will be triangle area. Okay, then we can find the Pa equal to 0.5 Ka gamma H1 square. Okay, where H1, okay, is the height of this vertical plane. Okay, and because of we have the alpha means the inclined surface. Okay, that means we have another edge because of this inclined surface. Okay, then H1 is higher than H, means the height of the wall only. Okay, so this is for the Rankin theory that we make the correction due to the inclined ground surface, okay, and the direction of the Pa is changing to be parallel to the ground surface. Okay, and if the stress distribution is triangle, that means the moment arm or the force, I mean the position of the Pa, okay, will equal to H 1 divided by 3. So, all is the stress distribution due to the soil itself. Okay, and if we have the surcharge Q as the uniform load or uniform surcharge, okay, we will take that Q almost the same as the soil layer. Okay, but if we have another type of the surcharge, okay, then we have to find the lateral pressure, okay, or the stress increment, but in this case in x direction. Okay, as we study in soil mechanics, okay, we find the delta sigma V, okay, is mean the vertical stress increment, okay, in vertical direction. Okay, but in this case, it is horizontal direction. Okay, so the first type of the load, okay, if it is point load, okay, that means the location of the point Q okay, point load Q, okay, will equal to X, okay, and we can find, okay, correspond with the H mean the height of the wall. Okay, if X equal to MH, okay, and Z equal to NH, okay, because we want to find the stress distribution. That means in this case, we will find from the top of the wall to the end of the wall. Okay, the data stress X in along the wall like this. And the typical stress distribution will be like in the chart like this. Okay, that means at the ground surface, okay, we will get the stress equal to zero. And then increasing with depth up to the highest point and then decreasing with depth. Okay, so this is not the same as a data signal V. Okay, in soil mechanics for data signal V, it will be maximum at the ground surface and then decreasing with depth. Okay, so in this case it's different. Okay, so and because this is the point load, okay, that means the unit in this case is will be force. Okay, mean kilonewton, something like that. Okay, but when we find, we will find at the stress, okay, that means sigma x. Usually when we have the surcharge load, okay, we will have the active or passive pressure, okay, due to the soil itself, and then we will find another stress distribution, okay, due to this external surcharge. Okay, we will not make the summation, okay, because otherwise the stress distribution shape is will be very complicated. Okay, then we find for the soil itself and for the external surcharge separately. Okay, and for the soil we find the PA and set that or set bar of the PA. Okay, in this case also, after we find the stress distribution, we have to find the force, resultant force P. Okay, it will be PX, and also we will get the set dot or set bar of the PX. Okay, so for the point load, okay, we can find the sigma X, okay, equal to TQ divided by 2 pi h squared multiplied with m squared n divided by m squared plus n squared, okay, total power by 5 divided by 2. Okay, and if there is no effect of the wall anchor, okay, then if m larger than 0.4, okay, sigma x will equal to 1.77 Q divided by S squared multiplied with M squared N squared divided by M squared plus N squared total power 3. And if M less than or equal to 0.4, okay, then sigma x will equal to 0.28 Q divided by S squared multiplied with N squared divided by 0.16 plus N squared total power 3. Okay, so you can find by the equation or you can open from this chart. The value of the in X axis is sigma X H squared divided by Q. Okay, we want to find this sigma x. Okay, then for the n will be from the 0 up to 1. Okay, compare with the h. Okay, and if m less than or equal to 0.4, okay, it will be this line, mean the maximum value. Okay, if 0.5, 0.6, or 0.7, okay, you can use interpolate. Okay, or otherwise use the equation, okay, to find the value. Okay, to use the chart, okay, so like if at 0.2, n is equal to 0.2, okay, and then intersect with the line, okay, and then with the value. Okay, if we know the value, we know Q, H also known, then we can find this sigma x. And from the equation, okay, Q, the unit is force, and divided by distance squared, that means the area. Okay, so sigma x is will be stress. Okay, this is for point load. Okay, another case, if it is line load. Okay, that means the length of the load is also infinity. Okay, along with the wall. Okay, for infinity also. Okay, that means the unit of the Q is will be force per one unit length. Okay, then when we find the sigma x, okay, this will be sigma x per one unit length also. Okay, and the same, okay, the position of the Q, okay, equal in x, okay, mean x measure far from the wall, okay, equal to mh, and sat equal to nh. We can find the stress distribution by this chart. Okay, the x axis is will be sigma x h divided by q. Okay, and y axis is n, mean from 0 to 1. Okay, for m less than or equal to 0.4. Okay, this is this line. Okay, mean the maximum line. Okay, this one for m 0.5 or m 0.7. Okay, or you can calculate from this equation. Sigma x equal to 4q divided by gamma h, okay, multiplied with m square n divided by m square plus n square. And powers are square. Okay, if m less than or equal to 0.4, sigma x will equal to 0.203 q divided by h multiplied with n divided by 0.16 plus n square. Okay, total are square also. And another case, okay, if it is slip load surcharge. Okay, so we can find from this equation, okay, sigma x will equal to q divided by h multiplied with beta minus psi beta cos 2 alpha. Okay, so what is the alpha and beta angle? Okay, because it is steep footing, it is steep load. Okay, that means we have the width of the load. Okay, and the length is infinity. Okay, and the distance from the load to the wall, okay, equal to m1. Okay, the width of the load equal to m2. Okay, for the beta angle, okay, so at any set that we want to find the sigma x, okay, we will draw the line from the beginning of the load and from the end of the load to that point. Okay, then we will get this beta angle. Okay, mean the line from the beginning and the end of the load up to the point that we want to find the stress. For the alpha angle, okay, it will be the angle from the vertical plane, okay, up to the center line, means line from the center to the point Z, okay, will be alpha angle, okay, or the line that divide bisector of this beta. So, this one, okay, we can find this sigma x. Okay, then with the Z is different, then beta and alpha also different. Okay, the stress distribution, okay, will be typically like this. Okay, as the same as other load. Okay, but we have equation, okay, in order to find this force P, okay, directly. Okay, so P equal to Q divided by 90 multiplied with H theta 2 minus theta 1. Okay, theta 1 means tan arctan of M1 divided by H, and theta 2 means arctan of M1 plus M2 divided by H. Okay, both in terms of degree, okay, because we divided by 90 degree. Okay, in case that we want to use the equation, okay, if that is the effect of the wall, okay, then we can use this equation. Okay, sigma x equal to 2q divided by H, multiply with beta minus psi beta cos 2 alpha. Okay, it's almost the same. Okay, just multiply with 2. Okay, mean the 2 times of the last equation. Okay, and to know the P, okay, we need to know this Z also. Okay, for Z, mean the position of the force PF, okay, will equal to H minus S squared multiplied with theta 2 minus theta 1 plus R minus Q minus 57.3 M2 H, okay, divided by 2 H theta 2 minus theta 1, where R equal to M2 plus M1 squared multiplied with 90 minus theta 2, and Q equal to M1 squared multiplied with 90 minus theta 1. Okay, let's see the example. Okay, determine the lateral air pressure caused by a light load shown in the figure. Okay, we have Q about 20 kN per meter. Okay, and the distance from the wall is 2 meters. Okay, in this case, we assume that if the wall is very thin, then we use the same distance, 2 meters. And the height of the wall is 8 meters. Okay, then we find the M value. Okay, either it is larger than 0.4 or not. And we get M equal to X divided by H. Okay, that means 2, oh, sorry, it should be divided by 8. Okay, so then it should be 0.25. Okay, it's still less than 0.4. Okay, then sigma X will equal to 0.203 Q divided by H, okay, multiply with N divided by 0.16 plus N squared, so multiply total power 2 also. Okay, so this term is constant, okay, because all value is known. Then we get 0.203 multiplied with 20 divided by 8. Okay, 0.5078. And then we make the table. Okay, from set to 0, 2 meter, 4 meter, 6 meter, and 8 meter. And find the n. Okay, will be set divided by h. Okay, 0.25, 0.5, 0.751. Okay, then we get n divided by 0.16 plus n squared, total squared. 0.05, 2.97, 1.44, 0.74. Okay, and for the sigma x, okay, we'll use this term, 0.5078, and then multiply with n. We get 0.92, 1.72, 0.83, and 0.43. If we draw the stress distribution, here it will be as the dashed line. Here it is the curve. Here, but to find the resultant force, here, then we have to make it to be linear. Okay, then we will separate with small area. Okay, so like in this case, we divided every 2 meter. Okay, then it will be 7 area. Okay, area 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we get area 1, okay, for triangular 0.5 multiplied with 2.92 multiplied with 2. Okay, second area is rectangular. Okay, the third area also triangle again. Okay, fourth. And the fifth area, six. And the last one, 7. Then we get PA. Okay, 2.92 plus 3.44 plus 1.2 plus 1.66 plus 0.89 plus 0.86 and plus 0.4. Okay, then PA 11.37. Find the position of the PA, okay, by each area. We multiply with the moment arm. Okay, but in this case, I select the check moment at point O. Okay, that means at the initial of the wall. Okay, as at the top of the wall. Okay, then area 1, okay, will be 2/3 of the 2 meter. Okay, then multiply with 2/3 of this 2 meter. Okay, area 2, okay, will be 2 meter plus 1 meter. Okay, half of 2 meter. Okay, area 3 will be 2 meter plus 1/3 of the 2 meter. Okay, area 4, okay, this will be 4 meter plus 1. Okay, and area 5, this will be 4 meter plus 1/3 of 2. Okay, area 6, okay, will be 6 meter plus 1. Okay, area 7 will be 6 meter plus 1/3 of this 2 meter. Then we get sub bar equal to 3.39, okay, from point O. from this point, okay, then 3.39, about 3.4. Okay, with that, 11.37. Okay, so this is to find the lateral force, okay, due to the external surcharge. Okay, and to find this stress distribution is very important, okay, because if you find the stress incorrect, okay, in the next chapter, we will use this stress distribution, okay, to design. Okay, actually, we will use this Px and sub bar and Pa and sub bar for the design. Okay, and where is this from the stress distribution? Okay, that means it is very important. Okay, it will be the initial condition. If the initial is not correct, all the rest will be not correct also. So this is for the chapter 5. Okay, then we will use it for design in chapter 6.